So you think you can come to my show having forgone your daily stretches? Idiot! I have become limber! There comes a time in everyone's life where they must choose how to bend. Over or otherwise? I chose otherwise. Maybe you would have too had you not long ago dropped the proverbial contact lens of a contortionist perspective. A contortact lens, if you will. And much like your shame, it is transparent. Since I began my campaign of yoga, I have pretended to feel healthier than anyone who has ever lived, which makes me the best at it. None shall live, laugh, love in my way, yet I shall never stop recommending it. I'm Lyle Rath, and this is Pregame Discharge, the only video game show that's just had so much more energy lately. The Last of Us 2 is delayed indefinitely.
Wait, what am I talking about? It's definitely delayed. Silly.
This is obviously a result of the Big Rony. The game is probably still on track in some way, shape, or form. They just don't know when it's actually gonna get finished. But it's probably gonna be a couple months out from whenever these goofballs can safely get in a circle and cough on each other again, as is a crucial part of the game development process. Eyes up, dickhole! There's rumors afoot. Fun ones, no less. Apparently, Nintendo is working on porting all the previous 3D Mario games to the Switch. This is according to some guy who is definitely a reliable source. I don't know. All the other gaming publications are talking about it, so we're talking about it too. The rumor goes that Nintendo is going to try to create like a 3D version of the Mario All-Stars game for the Super Nintendo, but also that Mario 3D World was going to get its own designated polish-up and re-release. But double also, maybe they're not doing that, and maybe they're going to re-release them remade in their entirety, sort of like a Link Between Worlds. And the most exciting part, which may or may not be true, keep in mind, is that they're finally going to do another Paper Mario that isn't gimmicky poo-poo dog shit for moron babies. Like you. This is big if true, and it should be, because for a company that has such a propensity to re-release their old shit, it's kind of baffling to me that you can play Final Fantasy VII on the Switch, but not Mario 64. Playdead's third game got a little teaser clip. It's yet another stylized, moody side-scroller about a little gray character in a gray world, but I guess if it's not broke, don't break it. This one seems to be on some sort of a the moon or something. Indivisible got an update that adds New Game Plus and couch co-op. This is pretty cool. It doesn't seem like the co-op is gonna totally overhaul the game. It's more like a little brother mode. But as free updates go, any kind of multiplayer is a pretty good one. Rogue Legacy 2 got announced. That was about it. They announced that they were gonna announce it on April Fool's, and then actually announced it on the day after April Fool's. So maybe the real April Fool was us all along. A side note, I am recording this a day after April Fool's, so if any of these stories turn out to be just goofs, it's not my fault. I am exclusively reporting the ones that seem like real ones because, you know, I make jokes and shit here anyway. But who knows? Maybe Sea of Thieves is really not coming to Steam. And they've fooled me with their rousing joke. Dragon's Lair, the 1980s full motion video arcade game that has been kept alive over the decades by porn artists, has apparently had the rights secured by Netflix. They're also throwing Ryan Reynolds' name around as if they're trying to do some reverse Deadpool situation to him. Like, oh no, look at all the Dragon's Lair fans that'll be really disappointed if you don't do this.
You're not watching it for him. You're watching it for this bitch, you loud masturbator.
I'm Lyle Rath, and this has been Pregame Discharge. Come back next week, and I won't done tell nobody what I heard.